Myself, Chitra Thyagarajan. I have got already around 296 this year. My option is Tamil literature. I hail from Viluppuram. My father is a retired employee of Railways. I completed my BTech in engineering. I have been working with IBM India Private Limited for 4 years. I have been preparing for civil services since the year 2012. This is my last attempt. The first three attempts, I was not able to clear my preliminary. Last two attempts, I was not able to make it to in mains. And this attempt, I got the rank on 296. My option is Tamil literature. My hobbies are singing, going out with friends, going to heritage places and places which are under ASI in my district. I mean, always pursuing my hobby. I used to go for movie first day, first show. Such things I have never compromised in my civil services preparation. But the thing is, like, it is very important that we have to pursue our hobby that makes us feel light, because the preparation in itself is being very stressful. We have to have an outlet. My preliminary strategy is like, in 2013, 14, 15, I was not able to make it in my preliminary. In 2013, I got around 68 marks in my paper 1. 2014, I got 83. 2015, I got 107, but the cutoff was 107.34. 2016, I was able to make it with a very high margin of, like, I got 132. The thing is, first, I was not knowing which books I have to study, what all I have to study. Knowing the books is not important, but knowing what to study and how to study the book is very important. For example, I was, for history, I was relying on Bipin Chandra, Modern India, NCERT, Spectrum, and Ancient India and Medieval India from Tamil Nadu History textbook. For geography, I was relying only on NCERT, India Physical Geography, Fundamentals of Physical Geography, Goetz-Anglian. These three books I was depending on for my geography preparation. And I used to solve a lot of question papers. Especially, I joined a SMART test series for a preliminary. I have never been to GS classes for preliminary earlier. The SMART classes, especially Sadiq sir's history classes, were so helpful that after 2016, I joined SMART test series in 2015 only, for the 2016 preliminary. Since then, I've joined the preliminary test series with sir. I never used to make anything wrong in ancient, medieval and modern India. So that was always helpful for me in having an edge in preliminary over the other subjects. And for economics, I was following Shankar Ganesh, and for current affairs, I never had the opportunity to go for daily newspapers. I used to go through current affairs daily magazines, like I used to go through for monthly magazines of current affairs. And to be honest, I was never able to read the paper daily. I used to read just the gist of the paper once a week. For mains, it is like whatever the static part, whatever I have read for my preliminary, I just followed it. Apart from that, I used to follow the mains material, like all the current affairs newspapers that I used to, like only the editorial part I used to get, and I used to read that. Very important thing, especially with respect to my optional Tamil literature, is answer writing. I at most give most priority to go and attend the test. It should be very least probable that I would miss any test. And GS also, this time I have extremely tried my best to attend all the tests. I feel that answer writing is something very, very important. And also, when it comes to ethics, having a standard formula in writing the ethics case studies doesn't work. This is what the lesson I have learned this time. Whatever we feel like, whatever we feel that we will do it in that time, that we have to record in the case studies. Instead that going on for options, like what will you do when the question does not ask for any options, is something that is not working. This is what I feel. In the interview preparation, I was first relying on grooming myself. First thing is, I had to take care of everything that I wanted on that day, right from the dress and to whatever is that is needed for that day, to groom myself well. Something that was first thing that I was focusing on. Second thing, when it comes to, it's obvious, it is very important that we should have a good content to talk. So making a good DAF while we apply for our DAF is very important. Without having a DAF which is particularly very well articulated, then that is the one thing that is going to support us on the interview day. Either it can be a boon or it can be a bane. It's how that we have articulated our DAF. Third thing when it comes to interview preparation is we have to have a thorough knowledge of current affairs, that which is going on for the last 2-3 months. And it is also very important that whatever every single letter which is mentioned in the DAF, that we should have a thorough knowledge about it. Any question that is being asked in the DAF, we should be able to answer and we should be able to convince. I have attended the mock interview with Smart Leaders. In that, the board members were very cordial and he appreciated me to a greater extent, which gave me a boost to prepare myself for the final attempt. Without that, I was feeling a little nervous whether I am doing it perfectly. But once after that, I have attended this mock interview, I felt that, okay, I am doing well. So such kind of a confidence that we will get only when we face mock interviews. And for that, Smart Leaders really helped me. A friend of mine who is called Satish Ayaris, he has told me that to go and join the SCS in Smart in 2015. With his advice, I joined the prelims test series with Smart. I used to come like around 2 o'clock and I go back by 8:30, though it is very late for me to reach home. But I really like the classes of Sir Sadiq Sir whenever he used to take history. I was feeling like that I will be able to relate myself to the stories that he says. He used to give a lot of and especially whenever he talks about Buddha, that attracts me a lot. The polity and the peculiar questions, the small differences that Sivaraj sir will make in the polity questions, it has a lot of effect in our final exam, because we will be in searching for the word, whether it is not required or it is required. We will also be able to find out what exactly is the question. Such kind of an reasoning will develop when we attend the polity questions of Sivaraj well sir. And for mains, I always used to show my essays to Sadiq sir, and he used to say that I am writing well, and he used to say that here and there, like add more points here and there. That has certainly helped me in my mains, especially in my essay. And my ethics paper also, I used to show it to Sadiq sir. He has given a lot of insights onto it and how to develop my paper. The last thing is my interview preparation. As I've said earlier, the mock interview which I have attended and the board, the appreciation of the board members have certainly given me a confidence. And when I was even after attending the interview, I was in constant touch with Sadiq sir and Sivaraj well sir. They have said that I will make it this year. That was a ray of hope for a person like me who are in the fag end of this journey. It was the healing touch which they have given me, and I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Sadiq sir, Sivaraj well sir, Suresh sir, and also the entire Smart Leaders team for providing a platform for people like me. Though I am not from a very great background, I am from a very simple background. I never know anything about civil services until I completed my engineering. So without the support of Smart Leaders, people like me would have not been able to make it. I wholeheartedly thank Smart Leaders and the team for the support they have given to me.